Hello folks, here's Professor Francisco Gomez, and today we are on the third video of the series about intermittent fasting. Today we are going to discuss the main protocols of intermittent fasting. So let's get to it. The first one we are going to talk about is the 5-2 fasting, which you fast for 2 days a week and eat for the other 5 days. That's the fasting protocol that I'm actually doing since 2014. Second will be the ADF, alternate day fasting, which you fast every other day. The third will be the TRF, time restricted feeding. And the fourth and last, the PR, prolonged fasting. Here we have the fasting 5-2, also known as 5-2 diet. For example, in my case, I fast from Monday to Tuesday and from Thursday to Friday. The lunch of Monday is my last meal. However, sometimes I consume 100, maybe 200 calories during 24-hour fasting, which is almost nothing compared to a regular day. Then, on the other day, Tuesday morning, I do not have breakfast, no snacks. I will resume eating at noon. And this cycle I repeat from Thursday to Friday every week. That has been my fasting routine since 2014. The fasting 5-2 has been studied by Dr. Walter Longo, Dr. Madison, Dr. Fontana, and Dr. Verity, among other scientists. However, the popularization of this diet was due to a BBC documentary that Dr. Michael Mosley produced in 2012. He tried the fasting 5-2 diet, published a book, and since then the idea of fasting spread. But he also modified the diet because he could not cope going without food for 2 days intermittently. Thus, he decided to add 600 calories a day to make it easier. ADF, alternate day fasting. With this protocol, you eat every other day. As you see, it's much tougher than doing the 5-2 fasting. The ADF has been studied mainly by Dr. Christopher Verdi and Dr. Mark Batson. As I have said before, you eat every other day. Again, some modifications have been studied. In one example of modified ADF, on the fasting day, you eat 25% of what you would normally eat during a regular day. On the other hand, on the feast day, you are allowed to eat 125%. TRF, time-restricted feeding. Here we have the 16-8 diet, where you adopt a feed window of 8 hours a day. In this example, the first meal of the day is at 10 a.m. and you are allowed to eat up to 6 p.m. You can eat whatever you want during this 8-hour window. But use common sense. If you overeat during this window, you won't lose weight, of course. You will again find several clinical trials testing different times windows. If you want to try the TRF, I would recommend first experience with 14-10, where we eat for 10 hours and fast for the remaining 14 hours. The best results published so far are with the 16-8 TRF, where you eat for 8 hours and fast for the remaining 16. But don't rely only on publications, because the best diet is the diet that you can follow. You have to find a time window that you can maintain for a long period, because I'm sure you know that all diets work in the short term, but in the long run, you could eventually regain all the weight you lost. There are data, at least in the US, that on average, an obese person tried 18 different diets, and most of them, after 2 years, end up gaining all the weight back. Thus, the best diet is the diet that you see yourself doing for the rest of your life. You gotta change your lifestyle, and diet is just one facet of it. You see people that are obese, some morbidly obese, and they complain that they cannot lose weight. For some reason, their bodies are not adapted to losing weight. If they attempt everything, tried several diets, exercise, but at the end of the day, they always gain weight. The problem is that they are eager to lose all the excess weight they gain during decades in a very short period of time. That's just not feasible. You always see those miracle diets or exercise programs advertised on the internet, urging you to make a resolution. A new year resolution, and you say, I'm going to lose X amount of pounds in a few weeks. But that doesn't happen. You cannot stick to the diet, and then you get disappointed. Therefore, my recommendation is that you postpone breakfast and advance dinner. Not skip breakfast, just postpone it. If you are going to skip any meal, you should skip supper, not breakfast, and don't eat 2 to 3 hours before you go to bed. This is due to our circadian rhythm. Our circadian rhythm responds to light.
We believe that during the evolution of our ancestors, in the savannah of Africa, they were awake and actively searching for food for 12 hours and probably fasting or sleeping for another 12 hours.
Did you know that our digestive system does not work efficiently during the night? We're not meant to eat during the night. If you eat a heavy meal just before going to bed, your pancreas will not produce enough digestive enzymes and insulin. Your bowel movements will not be at its optimal speed. We know that our bowel movements are turned down around 10:30 p.m. and will only ramp up around 8:30 a.m. the following day. So, the take-home message: avoid ingesting any food except water 2 to 3 hours before going to bed. The fourth protocol is the prolonged fasting, where you fast for at least 4 days in a row with a minimum amount of calories. In the original BBC documentary, Dr. Mosley underwent 4-day fasting with just 50 calories a day, basically a bowl of soup and some crackers. Dr. Long and Dr. Madsen have been involved in prolonged fasting for at least 20 to 30 years. I recommend no more than 4 days a month, especially if you are starting fasting and do not know yet how your body responds to fasting. It's very tough. I have never attempted 4 days in a row. The maximum I have done has been 36 hours of fasting. It can be dangerous, I mean very dangerous, if not medically supervised. Now let's look into some recent publications. That's a paper published by Christopher Verity. Alternate day fasting for weight loss in normal weight and overweight subjects, a randomized controlled trial. This paper, 32 subjects were recruited to either do fasting versus a control group. You can see the graph on the right that they lost on average 5 kilos. If you are interested in a review article, that's a good one from Dr. Christopher Verity and Mark Hellestein. Alternate day fasting and chronic disease prevention, a review of human and animal trials. It's another publication from JAMA, from Christopher Verity and colleagues. The effect of alternate day fasting on weight loss, weight maintenance, and cardio protection among metabolically health obese adults. That's another review paper, meal frequency and time health in disease. That's a publication on TRF. 10-hour time-restricted eating reduced weight, blood pressure, and atherogenic lipids in patients with the metabolic syndrome. They got a group of patients with metabolic syndrome. They were on medications for diabetes, blood pressure, and cholesterol. At the baseline, they were eating for 14 hours a day, had elevated waist circumference, which is a measure of visceral fat. Visceral fat is the worst kind of fat you can have. Also, they have high blood pressure, high triglycerides, and low HDL cholesterol, which is the good cholesterol. Then, after 12 weeks of 10-hour time-restricted eating, they noticed a significant reduction in all healthy parameters, such as LDL cholesterol, the bad cholesterol, and hemoglobin A1c.
The hemoglobin A1c test measures the amount of circulating blood glucose for the past 3 months, whereas the regular glucose test measures the amount of glucose you have at that specific moment in time. That's an example of how prolonged fasting can be harmful. That's a case report where a 60-year-old man with type 2 diabetes that was undergoing a ketogenic diet decided to go into a prolonged fasting regimen. Let's see the outcome. On the fifth day, he collapsed at home, was taken to the hospital unconscious, highly dehydrated, and with acute metabolic acidosis. Fortunately, he recovered, but if this had happened during the night, or if he was alone at home, the outcome could have been much worse, if you know what I mean. So please, do not attempt to do prolonged fasting if you are not medically guided, or if you do not know how your body responds to prolonged fasting.
I will leave the link to these papers on the description. I have seen people in the internet, you might also have seen it, try to lose several pounds in a few days. That's feasible, that's easy. You can do those crazy fad diets and then you'll lose several pounds in a very short time. But at the long run, we all know that we'll gain back all this weight. My advice, and I believe that's the best strategy, is to change one thing at a time. Try to reduce the intake of highly processed food, like white bread, cakes, soda, all those food that you know that is bad for your health. Don't try to remove it, just reduce it. And also, you can try one of those diets that I showed you, one of those fast diets, and we'll see the result slowly. So the idea is to change your lifestyle, increase the amount of exercise you do a day, stay less sedentary, walk, go for a walk in the park, go for a walk around your house, stand up. Just by standing up will increase your metabolism by 10%. There are very little things that you can do in your routine that will make your life much better, and you can in the long run keep your weight low. You should find a diet that fits your lifestyle. Do not try to enter in a diet that is just only to lose weight. You have to see yourself doing this diet for the rest of your life. If it is something that is very difficult, whatever this diet is, ketogenic, paleo, vegan, if you cannot see yourself doing it for the rest of your life, do not even start it. I have selected intermittent fasting because it works.
We have been using intermittent fasting for millions of years. Almost all animals are forced to undergo some intensity of fasting periodically.
So it's not another fad diet. We don't have the results yet, like the clinical results showing what would be the benefits of fasting. But what we have so far, especially with animals,
is that fasting can have a very profound effect on your life and on your health. To sum up what I have showed you so far, we have the 5-2 diet, where you fast for 2 days a week. The other one is the alternate day fasting, where you fast every other day. Then we have the prolonged fasting, where you fast for at least 4 days in a row. Lastly, the time-restricted feeding, the TRF, where you select a window of the day where you are allowed to eat, and then you fast outside of this window.
That's it, folks. I have presented you 4 types of diets, intermittent fasting, for you to choose from. Or have I presented you 5? Have you realized that you also do fasting? Yes, everybody's fasting. As long as you sleep, you are fasting. Isn't it? The trouble is you might be fasting only for 6 hours. If you sleep 6 hours and you eat just prior to go to bed, and then after you wake up, you eat, you break your fast with your breakfast. That's why you're not losing weight. That's the reason you're gaining weight, because you keep eating the whole time you are awake. One strategy would be to spread this window of fasting. You wake up the same time and you postpone the breakfast. And then you advance the last meal of the day. Does it make sense to you that you fast? Hence, are you intending to increase your fasting period? Or are you going to try the other 3 alternate fasting that I proposed to you? In my case, I prefer the 5-2 diet. I had a serious problem. I had high cholesterol. I was about to go to statin, and I decided to do 2 days of fasting. Leave your comments below.
I'm curious to see what type of fasting you are planning to do. Have a nice day. In the next video, I'm going to go into detail how I do my 5-2 fasting. Bye.